All right, now recording has started and नमस्कार मोहा जी।
सर्वेषां नमो नमः। नमस्कारम् आचार्य महोदय।
नमस्कार मोहा जी। I am just sharing my screen here. Just let me know when you see my screen. And we have started the recording. Now, last week I told you I had written a table for all of us. So we will take a look at that as well. Let me see where to keep this. Okay, please let me know when you see my screen.
Are able to see a blank screen as of now, Acharya Mahoday.
And do you see me writing? Okay, yep, so okay, that means you can see. All right, mama naam Anshu. Aham pathami sanskritam. भवत्याः नाम किं मोहा महोदय?
मम नाम मोहा। भवतः किं करोमि नवीन महोदय?
अहं संस्कृतं पठामि मोहा महोदय। महोदया
आचार्य महोदय किं करोमि?
नो, किं करोसि, आई थिंक, राइट?
व्हाट वर यू सेइंग? से दैट अगेन।
द क्वेश्चन इज, या,
किं भवतः किं करोमि?
ओ, करोमि वुड बी विद अहम्, राइट? सो
या, करोसि
समबडी एल्स, यू विल से भवतः किं करोसि?
किं करोसि?
सो यू आर डायरेक्टली एड्रेसिंग दैट पर्सन ओनली, राइट? सो यू विल से किं करोसि?
आम, ओके।
हू एल्स इज देयर? ओनली संजीव जी, ओके। संजीव महोदय, भवतः नाम किं? भवतः किं करोसि? व्हाट डू यू से फॉर आर यू एबल टू हियर आचार्य महोदय?
श्रोणतु, यू कैन से श्रोणतु, बट
श्रोणतु संजीव जी, संजीव महोदय श्रोणतु वा?
और श्रुणो श्रुण
सर्वेशम नमो
श्रुति
नमः।
नमो नमः गीता महोदया।
नमो नमः, स्वागतम गीता महोदय। संजीव जी, ओ
श्रणोसि, ये कैन यू सी हियर ऑन माय स्क्रीन, आई
या
एम राइटिंग दैट
श्रुणोसि
आल्सो, सो यू कैन ऑलवेज
श्रुणोसि
स्क्रीन।
वा श्रुणोसि वा।
आई थिंक यू कैन आस्क गीता महोदया देन। संजीव जी लुक्स लाइक माइक
तो
प्रॉब्लम।
गीता महोदया नमस्ते। भवत्याः नाम किम्? भवत्याः किं करोसि? गीता महोदया
How to connect here? It's not connecting.
we can hear you, it is connected Gita ji.
Yeah.
नवीन जी, भवतः तव गृहे संस्कृतं वदसि किम्?
भवतः तव ग्रवे से दैट अगेन।
भवतः गृहे संस्कृतं वदसि किम्?
वदसि किम्?
And I have written it on the screen also. If you want to see, what did I just say? I said for Bhavatyaha, I just said
भवतः
that.
गृहे संस्कृतं वदामि वदसि वा? आम् आचार्य महोदय, अहं गृहे संस्कृतं वदामि।
उत्तमम् उत्तमम्। नाउ पास इट ऑन, जस्ट आस्क समबडी एल्स।
Who's
ओके।
there? Nobody. अमोहा जी। भवत्याः गृहे संस्कृतं वदसि वा? मोहा महोदया।
नवीन महोदय, मम गृहे संस्कृतं
ना वदसि,
न
ना वदामि, ना वदामि।
आश्चर्यं
केन
किमर्थं मोहजी?
आश्चर्यं किमर्थम्? इज दैट मो वाज दैट मोहाजी और वाज दैट गीता जी हु आंसर्ड?
मोहा
आई थिंक मोहा जी।
ओके 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 ओके। तो आचार्य जी आस्क्ड किम अर्थम?
यू सेड अर्धम और समथिंग एल्स आचार्य जी?
आई सेड किमर्थम, सो आई विल लेट मी राइट दैट ऑल्सो।
ओके okay.
किमर्थम मीन्स
And how would I say speaking?
वदामि, सो दैट इज व्हाट यू
Speak.
आंसर्ड राइट। वद वद इज द स्पीकिंग वर्ब, सो वेदर यू स्पीक देन यू विल से अहम वदामि, और यू कैन से अहम प्रयत्नम करोमि, सो आई एम
करो
ट्राइंग। और प्रयत्न करोमि, सो इवन दैट इज इनफ. इफ यू आर ट्राइंग विद समबडी वेदर दे आंसर और नॉट, इट इज फाइन, बट एटलीस्ट यू विल गेट योर प्रैक्टिस एंड दे विल डेफिनेटली बी क्यूरियस, बिकॉज एनी लैंग्वेज पीपल लर्न, जर्मन, फ्रेंच, सो मैनी डिफरेंट लैंग्वेजेस विच आर टफर देन आवर लैंग्वेजेस. सो ओके, नाउ पास ऑन द क्वेश्चन मोहाजी. आई थिंक वी हैव अ न्यू जॉइनी, वर्षा जी, सो यू कैन आस्क वर्षा जी एंड गीता जी,
क्वेश्चन
येट टू
होता
स्पीक,
है हमारे
संजीव
दस
जी इज
क्वेश्चन
ऑल्सो
में,
येट टू स्पीक, सो जस्ट चूज
डू आई
योर.
रिपीट द क्वेश्चन?
या यू कैन रिपीट, प्लीज रिपीट.
भवत्याः गृहे संस्कृतं वदसि किं वर्षा महोदया?
न वदामि महाजी, एम
आश्चर्यं किमर्थं वर्षा महोदय?
राइट? आई डोंट नो हाउ टू आंसर दैट.
यू कैन जस्ट से प्रयत्नं करोमि.
ओके, प्रयत्नं करूंगी.
अहम गृहे संस्कृतं वदामि. सो अहं प्रयत्नं करोमि. गीता महोदय, ओके वर्षा जी, यू कैन पास ऑन द क्वेश्चन.
ओके, भवत्याः गृहे संस्कृतं वदसि किं गीताजी?
न, मम गृहे संस्कृतं न वदामि. केवल शृणोमि, संस्कृतं श्लोकं शृणोमि.
ओ
आई थिंक इट्स
उत्तम उत्तम.
केवलम केवल केवल और केवलम, राइट?
हाँ,
केवलम, या
केवलम.
केवलम.
केवला मम गृहे संस्कृतश्लोकं शृणोमि.
उत्तमम. सो व्हाट इज
सो फॉर
द विभक्ति
श्रणोमी यू
फॉर,
कैन, यस गो अहेड,
सॉरी,
गो अहेड, गो अहेड.
या नो, व्हाट इज द विभक्ति फॉर विथ, विभक्ति फॉर विथ, यू नो, आई एम स्पीकिंग विथ, हाउ डू यू से दैट?
बट जस्ट टेल मी व्हाट डू यू वांट टू से एंड देन वी विल ट्राई.
ओके, आई वांटेड टू से मम गृहे अहम स्पीकिंग विथ, अहम स्पीकिंग संस्कृतम विथ मम बालिका.
ओ सो यू कैन से
तो
अहम मम बालिका च संस्कृतम वदामि. सो मतलब मीन्स यू आर सेइंग दैट आई एंड माय डॉटर स्पीक संस्कृत टुगेदर, इवन दैट इज फाइन.
ओके,
यू कैन पुट द सेम सेंटेंस.
सो इट इज लाइक अहम मम बालिका च संस्कृतं वदामि.
करेक्ट.
ओके ओके, धन्यवाद. अच्छा,
बट नाउ यू आर सेइंग दैट यू एंड योर डॉटर स्पीक टुगेदर, राइट? सो दिस
या
टाइम यू विल नॉट से वदामी, यू विल से वदतौ. यू रिमेम्बर
वदतो. ओके, या
द्विवचन.
वदतो द्विवचन, या वदतो. ओके ओके, या मेक सेंस.
और इफ यू वांटेड टू से अहम मम बालिका च मम बालकः च संस्कृतम् देन वदन्ति, बिकॉज दैट वुड बी
वदन्ति,
बहुवचन.
प्लूरल प्लूरल, या बहुवचन. आम आम आम, उत्तम.
बहुवचन. ओके, गीता महोदया प्रश्नं पृच्छतु. संदीप महोदय इज स्टिल रिमेनिंग, आई थिंक.
भवतः संजीव महोदय गृहे संस्कृतं वदसि किम्?
Am I audible, आचार्य?
आम आम
okay.
इदानीं श्रणोमि श्रवणं करोमि सो फॉर
फर्स्ट वदसि राइट
करेक्ट सो शी ओके यू कैन आस्क योर क्वेश्चन अगेन गीता जी आई थिंक संजीव जी माइट वांट टू हियर वंस मोर
संजीव महोदय भवतः गृहे संस्कृतं वदसि वा
ना अहं गृहे संस्कृतं प्रयत्नं करोमि अहं गृहे संस्कृतं श्रवणं प्रयत्नं करोमि
ओके श्रवणं प्रयत्नं कृतः कदा वदसि संजीव महोदय
ना आचार्य
ओके मम प्रार्थना प्रयत्नं कुरु सर्वत्र प्रयत्नं कुरु अत्र प्रयत्नं कुरु गृहे प्रयत्नं कुरु सर्वत्र प्रयत्नं कुरु
अवश्य प्रयत्नं करोमि आचार्य महोदय
उत्तमं सर्वत्र सो डू यू रिमेम्बर अत्र तत्र सर्वत्र लास्ट टाइम डिड वी लर्न
नो वी लर्नड I think we just mentioned it, but I don't remember learning. But sarvatra, does it mean everywhere?
Yes.
Okay.
So atra is here. Aham atra asmi. महामहोदय त्वं भवत्याः कुत्र अस्ति
अहं गृहे अस्ति आचार्य महोदय
ओके तत्र सङ्गणकयन्त्रम् अस्ति
आम् अत्र सङ्गणक कम्प्यूटर् सङ्गणकम्
एण्ड् यू केन् पुट् यन्त्रम् आल्सो अलाङ्ग् वित् इट् एण्ड् इट् इस् नाट् नेसेसरि यन्त्रम् इस् आप्शनल्
Sangatam. Or you can you also call it as Sanganakam?
Ah, Sanganakam is actually correct.
Okay.
Sanganakah. Okay. So kam, when you say kam, then it is you are acting on it. So if
okay.
So Sanganakam is Dvitiya, right? So when you want to use Dvitiya, then use Dvitiya, not all the time.
Okay.
And similar word is ganak. Have you heard of ganak?
Ganak.
Numerals.
No.
Ganak is calculator.
Calculator.
Okay. Calculator. Okay.
Implied in the mean in the word itself. Ganana.
Correct. So ganak is calculator and sanganak is computer. So atra tatra tatra is there atra is here sarvatra is everywhere Naveen mahoday bhavatah kutra asti
aham atra asti
atra kutra
aashcharyam
atra
kutra asti
अहम फ्लावर माउंट नगरे टेक्सास राष्ट्रे अमेरिका देशे अस्ति।
उत्तमम् उत्तमम्। तत्र वर्षा अस्ति।
ज्वाले अस्ति। देयर इज अ वाइल्ड फायर गोइंग ऑन देयर।
ओ
I'm sorry,
टेक्सास राष्ट्रे वर्षा नास्ति महोदय।
वर्षा अस्ति। कैलिफोर्निया राष्ट्रे वर्षा नास्ति। कैलिफोर्निया राष्ट्रे अग्नि अग्नि महोदय।
वन अग्नि।
हाँ वन वन अग्नि अस्ति।
But do we say it's Davanal is a pure Hindi word?
No, Davanal anal is also Sanskrit. We can say Davanal.
I think that's more suitable, right?
It is, but one more thing is usage also. So we can use Davanal, but when you say when you say one agni, it is more understandable. So there are sometimes words that you may want to speak only with Sanskrit speakers, then Davanil is okay. But if you are speaking to common general public, then a more common word is
then ज्वाला,
more suitable. वन अग्नि और ज्वाला, वन वन ज्वाला. You can make words because Sanskrit is very extremely flexible. वन ज्वाला.
I don't know, but
one more word.
You were silent. I mean, like you were speaking, but I was not able to hear you. Was everybody able to hear Acharyaji, or is it just me?
When?
Just now, just a few seconds ago.
Seconds ago, when I was writing this one Agni Jwala around that.
Yeah.
Okay. Others can tell if they heard or not. वर्षा महोदया
इट वाज क्वाइट देयर वाज नो टॉकिंग
ओ सो मे बी सम नेटवर्क ग्लिच हैपेंड सो आई वाज सेइंग बट बिकॉज संस्कृत इज फ्लेक्सिबल यू कैन से वन अग्नि वन ज्वाला और दावानल ऑल थ्री आर करेक्ट
ओके
व्हाट वुड यू कॉल नेटवर्क आचार्य महोदय
Network. I have to think because I think we have to construct a word. Sometimes when there are modern words which were not present in the older times, you may not have words directly available in that language at that time. But we can make words.
In Hindi, we can find a link from that network in Hindi. Sanchar.
Sanchar Tantra. Huh. संचार तंत्र शुड बी फाइन फॉर नेटवर्क तंत्र इज यूज्ड फॉर
दैट विल बी मीडिया संचार तंत्र विल बी मीडिया राइट
मीडिया इज व्हाट डू यू से सूचना एंड प्रसारण मंत्रालय दैट इज द ब्रॉडकास्टिंग मीडिया
विल बी समथिंग एल्स
माध्यम मीडिया
दैट इज द संचार
One second. So let us write that. Suchana is information. Prasaran or Prasaranam is
broadcast.
then Sanchar Tantra should be network. But yes, if we find better word for media, can somebody think of media? What would they, what you call them? Sanchar is not really media, because Sanchar means spreading information, and Sanchar Tantra means the medium that you use to spread information, and it is okay for using for network. But for media, what would you like to say?
Madhyam means platform, no?
Madhyam is medium.
Medium.
So yeah. Madhyam is medium. That is correct. So I think media is a plural for Madhyam, but then it has a different meaning.
In Hindi, we call it Sanchar Madhyam. Sanchar Madhyam is the word for media.
So then Sanchar Tantra is network. Sanchar Madhyamam would be media.
Okay.
Because both have Sanchar.
Again, you have distinction
between.
But if
we find better words, please bring them to the class. If we find better words for something, you discover something, please bring, so that we can all get enlightened. Yes, Geeta, you were saying something. Sorry.
I said there are again different medias, no? Print media, visual media, all that.
So you can distinguish based on that also. So drashya madhyamam, print. What would you say for print? In Hindi you say chapa, but
I've got a suggestion, Acharya Mahode.
Yes, go ahead, Mahaji.
There is this news which comes on DD News in Sanskrit. I don't know
correct.
The timing, but on and off, once in a while I have seen them.
Yes.
So I think if you see that, and then we will get to know a lot of words and even sentence formations.
Yes, so that will be nice. Uttamam, Mohadi, Dhanyavad. Doordarshan Sanskrit Prasaran. So please listen to this, find out the times. I have heard that a few times. I have seen that a few times. And there is one member of parliament also from Odisha who always speaks in Sanskrit. So it is a pleasure to hear him, because he speaks very simple Sanskrit. It's easy to understand.
Saranga.
Sarang, correct. Sarang Dev, is it? Sarang.
Saranga. Yeah, maybe something like that. I remember his name because there is a beautiful rag in Saranga, which is my favorite
Saranga.
Rag. That's how I
remember. Okay, nice. Now, I am making a table, which I mentioned last time also, but I... Okay, Sanjeev ji has just found out. He has given us a related word, Prasar Madhyamani. So, yeah, media is... Prasar Madhyamani. Do we have space here? And media is always a plural word, so that is why you have a Madhyamani, the ani at the end. Media is always used as a plural word.
Prasar is broadcasting, right? Because
correct.
Prasar Bharati we have in All India Radio Akashvani.
Correct. So Sanjeev ji must have found out somewhere. Sanjeev ji, you can enlighten us.
Prasar is broadcasting.
That is
Print, I
correct.
guess, patra, patra, something with patra, it will be.
You can say likhit madhyam is print. Even that is okay. But then you are distinguishing different media. The likhit madhyam versus darshaya madhyam, so visual medium. But this sounds okay. Prasar Madhyam or Sanchar Madhyam. So Sanchar and Prasar are similar words, which mean similar, which have similar meanings. So it should be okay. We can form net words. So there is no problem. We as long as we agree to use that word, we can use it. And it sounds okay. It sounds.
आम
इंटरनेट में
आम
भी समझ
आचार्य
लो
माँ
मैं अंतरजाल और अंतर
व्हाट वर्षा जी
इंटरनेट इज अंतरजालम
अंतरजालम नाइस
अंतर और अंतरा समथिंग
अंतरजालम
अंतर और
अंतरजालम
अंतर
या वन ऑफ
वर्ड नो
What, Geeta ji?
अंतरजाल इज हिंदी वर्ड
That is why we put a jalam at the end.
Yeah.
That
So
has
the
lot
one of
of
the things,
words. Yeah, go ahead.
yeah, one of the you bring up a uttamam point,
Point.
Acharya Mahode, because when we stop creating words, that's when the language slowly dies. So if we have to create words as we whatever we whatever words we need to use, we need to create those words in our own languages. So if
करेक्ट
we stop doing that, that's not
शब्दानां
a good sign.
निर्माणं कुर्वन्तु सर्वेषां
And people, you know, I've encountered in everyday life, I encounter people saying, people sarcastically asking, "Oh, what is the word for this in Telugu?" Like, first use the words that are present. You can at least use those. We will come up with words for these, and we can use them. Like, they won't even use the existing language itself, they'll be asking, "What is the word for this?" That. Yeah.
Acharya, I have one doubt. Now you have written Shabdaha
No, I have to correct that. That is what I am correcting.
Nirmar, no,
Shabdasya
Nirmar
Nirman.
noun Nirman na. If I make a shortcut by writing the dot on top of na, still becomes Nirmanam, no? How will I know when should I write ma and when should I write the dot
Most
on
of
top?
the words which have the at the end are more suitable for the ma with the halant. You will find very few words which are okay with the anuswar. So, for example, aum. So, aum is always written with the anuswar. And it's not just anuswar, it is a full Chandra Bindu. But there are, so for example, you say phalam, pushpam. So these are not exchangeable. So when you want to write phalam, you have to write the ma. You do not, it is a slightly erratic Sanskrit when you actually write phalam like this. This will be understood, but this is not okay. So people consider the Sanskrit acharyas consider this a slightly polluted Sanskrit. But we will see when such words come, when we have to write a dot with the anuswar, I will tell you. But till then, practice the ma separately because it's not exchangeable. So you cannot use phalam and phalam say in the same way. This is not the same. Is that understandable, Geeta ji? Was that your question? Geeta Mahodaya?
Yeah, there was a disconnect. I again got that.
Wow, so you asked a question and then disappeared.
Yeah, my Wi-Fi is still giving me trouble.
No, that is okay. But did others hear this, what I just said, or was it a glitch on my side?
Aham shrunomi.
Okay, so now can you explain to Geeta Mahodaya the same thing?
In Sanskrit,
if we can use no, anything is fine. Explain why that dot need not be used with every ma word.
What Acharya Mahodaya said was that this dot, which is called anuswar, anuswaram, right?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, anuswaram need not be used for all words ending with the sound. So for some words need to be, we should use ma ant. We used to end with the akshar ma itself. So for example, phalam, although you can write it with the anuswaram, but Sanskrit scholars believe that that's a wrong usage of anuswaram. So you should use, for phalam, you have to use halant with a ma for phalam. So that's what Acharya Mahodaya said. I guess as we progress learning further, we'll understand when to use anuswaram more. And yeah.
Correct, yeah. Correct. Yeah. Thank you, Naveen Mahode.
Thank you. Did I say Vandanam or Dhanyavadam?
Dhanyavadam. Both are okay. Dhanyavadam is more common. Vandanam is okay. Vandanam is less common, but it is more strong because you are bowing down. So it is...
Okay.
It is okay. Slightly a stronger emotion. So just use it if you really want to bow down.
Subhamastu. What else? is that okay if we say Subhamastu when the people say Dhanyavada, Dhanyavadaha, Acharya Mahodaya?
So you are trying to say something like you are welcome or it's
okay, yeah,
it's nice, it's good, it's all good.
Yeah, yeah.
Yeah, Shubhamastu is okay.
Okay.
If you were actually in front of each other, you might just do a namaskar and bow down, actually bow down. So when somebody says Dhanyavada to you, then you can really do that gesture,
yeah
slightly better, but yeah, just on phone or in a conference like this, Shubhamastu is good enough.
Oh, astu.
All right. So yes,
what is the difference between tathastu and evamastu?
Tathastu,
evamastu, I guess, means evamastu is what you wish should come true, right?
See, slight, yeah. Evamastu is, what am I doing? Evamastu is aisa hi ho, or it should happen like this, like this, like.
Mm-hmm.
And Tathastu is similar. So when you actually start translating it sounds similar, because Tathastu would be let it happen like what you said. So it must happen like that. So it slight change that what you said is let it happen like that. And Evamastu is we agree that this must happen. So
Yeah.
this versus that. So this is something which is agreed between two of you or 100 of you. But that is like your thought, what you are thinking, tathastu. So whatever is in your mind, let it happen.
You can simply say Tvam Swagatam. You are
Tava
welcome.
swagatam. हाँ, तव स्वागतम, और जस्ट से स्वागतम. सो देर इज नो नीड ऑफ तव ऑल द टाइम. देर आर राइट, सो स्वागतम.
स्वागतम
त्वम मीन्स यू, सो यू आर, बट यू वांट टू से योर
यू आर
योर
वेलकम
स्वागतम, राइट?
यू आर वेलकम तो
ओ नहीं, बट सी व्हाट यू आर डूइंग इज लिटरल ट्रांसलेशन ऑफ इंग्लिश इन संस्कृत. बट सी, यू आर वेलकम डज नॉट रियली मीन एनीथिंग. इफ यू थिंक ऑफ इट इन इंग्लिश, यू आर वेलकम विच मीन्स आई एम वेलकमिंग यू, राइट? सो नाउ व्हेन यू ट्रांसलेट इट इन योर ओन लैंग्वेज, आई वुड लाइक टू से दैट आई वेलकम यू. आई डोंट वॉन्ट टू से यू आर वेलकम, बिकॉज दैट लिटरल ट्रांसलेशन लूजेज इट्स मीनिंग, राइट? सो यू कैन सिंपली से
हाँ
स्वागतम. सो जस्ट बी केयरफुल व्हेन यू ट्रांसलेट अदर लैंग्वेजेस इन टू योर ओन, और मे बी इवन संस्कृत, यू डोंट वॉन्ट टू लिटरली ट्रांसलेट, बिकॉज समटाइम्स मीनिंग विल चेंज. So understand the meaning and then translate. So then it will be safer for the language also. Okay, so what I was writing here is that table. Are you also able to write it down somewhere on a paper or somewhere?
Yes.
Okay. So, first we will write few words which are examples of this. But now I am going to also write few additional qualifiers so you will understand what we are doing. So, Lata is a Striling noun. Gajah is Pulling noun. And Phalam is Napunsakling. So now do you see the difference? Something that ends in a and e is not always Striling, but you can put the rule the other way. Striling shabd usually end in a or e. Usually.
आम
Similarly, the words which end with a, just a, the a sound, so you will not see a physical and with the visarg, those are usually pulling shabd. Like the gajah. Gajah, you all understand? The elephant.
Elephant, but how do you say
Female gajah.
female, yeah.
Oh, right now let us hold on to
Okay.
that. One word at a time. So Lata is Lata, you me understand what does it mean? Lata is usually a name also, but it has a meaning.
Noted.
Creeper, creeper, creeper,
Noted.
right?
Creeper.
A bale in Hindi and creeper in English. Gajah and phalam, you all understand. So you will notice that the words where you see the ma at the end are usually napunsakling. Phalam, pustakam. You remember pustakam? Now, let me
read. Yantram.
Yantram.
Yeah.
Ganakam. Now, let us write. That or he or
Sanjay Mahoday just said.
Dhanyavadam. Recording is important. What would you say for recording? That is your assignment.
Uttamam.
Make word. Find out.
Uttamam.
So whatever is your Griha Karya, I will circle it in a different color so that you would remember. Okay.
Last time you told us to find out about the comparisons and differences between Sanskrit and Prakrit.
What was that? Between Sanskrit and?
Prakrit, no?
Prakrit versus Sanskrit. What was the history about it? Do you have some information on that?
No, because I'm seeing the book. Last Griha Karya was that. I'm seeing the book. I forgot it.
Nice. So at least you saw the Griha Karya. That what was the Griha Karya? Nice. Okay. So till you find out, we will believe what I said last time, that Prakrit got named as Sanskrit because of the beauty of it. So when you say the beautiful Prakrit, you say Sanskrit.
Yeah.
It's the language of the gods, they say.
Those are all separate adjectives for the language. But what is the real Deva Bhasha? Yes, it is called Deva Bhasha. That is correct. And that means we are all Devi Devtas. And it is obvious that because Ishvara Sarvatra Asti, so Ishvara Asti, Moha Mahodaya Devi Asti, Gita Mahodaya Devi Asti, so Sarvesham Devi Devta. Okay, so what would you say for Lata? For he or she or that? What would you use here for Lata? So I will write the first one and that will help you to tell me the next one. For Gajah, what would you say? So now with every time we write something, we will try to complete a statement also. So sa lata, ka lata,
sa lata,
sa lata means she is lata. Now lata can be actually a creeper or the person, but in both cases it will be always sa lata. So in English or some other languages, you might imagine that creeper is an napunsakling, but not in Sanskrit. In Sanskrit, Lata is a lady. So Lata is Stri and it will always be Sa Lata. Alright.
Uttamam.
Similarly, Sah Gajah. And what would you say for Phalam?
Tat. Phalam.
Uttamam. Now, let us try a visheshan or adjective. So, I am giving, I think I have given you this word, but not in this form. So let us understand it, and I think you will be able to understand. Harita Lata. Is that understandable?
That's green paper.
Harita.
So now this is something important to understand, that adjectives change its gender according to who is it describing. So you might say dhavalah gajah, right? Which means the white elephant. But when you want to say the green creeper, green lata, then it is dhavala gaja. Sorry, dhavala lata. Right?
Mata Saraswati ko hum log dhavala kehte
hain. Correct. So, yeah, so now when we learn Sanskrit, you will realize lot of times you use some words and sentences which you are already aware. You may have heard of this one, and we will talk about this after this table, but I am giving you this example right now. Have you heard of this? Tattvamasi.
Yeah, you are the one.
In Brahma's sense, when we say Aham Brahmasmi, and we say Tattvamasi also, which means I am also Brahma, and you are also Brahma. So this Asi.
These are from different ved. I had, yes, I recollect we were getting this Upanishad Ganga. After Ramayana.
Yeah.
Correct. So there was one particular episode which was focusing on Tattvamasi.
Exactly.
Clearly said every Ved, Aham Brahmasmi comes from Rig Ved, and Tattvamasi comes from Yajur or Sama.
Another one. Okay.
Yeah. But every Ved has this theme that you are the Brahma.
Correct.
Tattvamasi is from Upanishad, I guess. Chandogya
Upanishad. One of the Vedas.
Okay.
But not Rig Veda.
Yeah, if we find more information about it, please bring it, definitely. Now, one thing to understand is the Upanishad was written to explain the Veda. So they have a relation. So if there is something in Upanishad, it is definitely possible that the original thing was in some Ved, Atharva Ved, Yajur Ved, one of them, and then it also appeared in Upanishads. So does that make sense, Varshaji?
Astu. Astu.
Okay, so now dhavalah gajah, or you can, maybe this is not practically true, but haritah gajah. Maybe you have painted the elephant green, so haritah gajah is possible, but I'm just giving you the example that the adjective, the visheshan, will change its gender according to the noun. All right, now
Simplarly. I remember this Hindu Tushar Ha Dhavala. So for Saraswati it is, so I guess it is Dhavala.
Exactly. So now you can never say Madhurah Phalam, because you are describing a Napunsakling. The Phalam automatically means it is Napunsak, neuter gender. So you will always want to say Madhuram Phalam.
Madhuram Phalam. Okay.
You would have heard that bhajan is also there, na? Adharam Madhuram. Have you heard that?
Yes.
Beautiful.
Madhurashtakam. Madhurashtakam.
So you can learn a lot of neuter gender words from that, because it is, I think, almost everything is Madhuram Madhuram there. Adharam Madhuram.
Phalitam Madhuram. So phal is a, yeah, again a neuter gender, the way you have written.
Now, This table is extremely useful, so that is why I made this last week for all of you. In my book, I noted it down. So this is the time when we are getting time. Now let us try a kriya with this.
Kriya is a verb, no?
Verb, yes. So Lata Vikasati. Understandable?
Growing, Vikasati.
It grows or it is growing. Lata Vikasati. For Gaja, you want to say something? Gaja Chalati.
Chalati.
Or Dhavati is also.
Dhavati.
Dhavati. Tishthati is also nice. Tishthati, you remember Tishthati?
Yeah. Yeah.
Sitting.
Sitting, right? Yeah. Tishthati.
Tishthati, Chalati, Dhavati. Phalam. Patati. Because phalam cannot do too many things, it can only fall. So patati is one.
No, it can.
It can roll also. So what do you say for roll right now? I won't remember. So, but yes.
How do you say the vikasati?
Phalam vikasati. Okay. Vikasati.
Yeah. Okay. Okay.
Vikasati is fine. Phalam vadati, phalam chalati would be a little jokes in Sanskrit, but it can be used. So you might have seen Panchatantra or Hitopdesh Granth. Those you will see Dhenu vadati or phalam vadati or nadi vadati. So then there are a lot of impossible things which actually happen there, and it is a nice thing to see in those beautiful Kavya Grantha. Okay, now Prashna. So next one is Prashna, and I think I have asked one of them already. Kalata. For Gaja, what would you say for Prashna?
Kaha.
Kaha Gaja.
Gajaha.
And for Phalam?
Kim. Kim Phalam.
Correct.
Kim Phalam.
So now in this table, you will understand the difference between the Striling, Pulling and Napunsakling. There are few changes that you would have to do according to the gender of the word sometimes. So for example, this vikasati, chalati, dhavati, patati, kriya doesn't have a change. Kriya never changes based on gender. No effect. But others, you can see they change. Questions change, adjectives change, even he, she, that has a change. Now final is this. Or for even he or she, you want to say this one means here. Here versus there. So for Lata, what would you say? If
Lata,
Tat would be for Phalam.
Sha. For Lata, you would say Esha, right?
Esha, correct. So if Lata is next to you, then you would say Esha Lata, right? And if Lata is at a distance, then you will say
Sa.
Sa Lata. This is with distance. This is close.
Near, yeah.
Or near. Similarly, for Gajah.
Eshah
Gajah. Correct.
Eshah Gajah.
So now let me close this table properly. Forgive me.
It's like somebody is
circular lines.
Acharya Mahoday, can you please re-explain this? Esha. I couldn't understand.
Which one?
The last part. This. Esha.
Oh, so this is at nearby. So when something is near you, we say this. So if the this creeper, so then you will say Esharta. And even if it is a person, let's say you were sitting next to me, then I would say Esha, or I would say Esha Naam Moha Asti. But if you were at a distance from me, where I have to point at you at a distance, so then I would say Sa Moha or Sa Moha Moha. So you are at a distance. So it is like this. In English, you don't have a equivalent. So in English, whether you are near or far, I will always say she is Moha, right? But in Sanskrit, what is closer to you is Esha, and what is a little far from you is Sa.
The same Sa is used for as question also, na?
Ka. Question is Ka, right?
Sa, Saha, Kaha, like that. Sa kaha.
Correct. Sa kaha means who is he? When you say sa ka means who is she?
Ha. So the sa is dual purpose. Both
no.
For okay. Asking whether lady or showing at a distance.
No, no, no.
So it's the same thing, right? You are saying sa ka means who is that? But if I say Esha ka, which means I am saying who is this? So if you were sitting next to me, then I might say Esha ka, not Sa ka, because you are at next to me. Esha and Sa are exchangeable only based on distance. So you will use either Esha or Sa. Depending on distance. Naveen ji, you were adding something.
No, I was just saying, I just attended an introductory class yesterday from Samskrit Bharati, US.
Okay.
And the Acharya ji there, she was recommending to use hands while practicing Esha and you know, Sa. Eshah, Sah. When you're using those words, initially at least you practice you
with
your hands. Yeah, with action. Then that will make it easier to learn, and quickly you'll absorb the language. That's what she was saying.
So when I ask you showing this, do you see my screen? Do you see this?
Huh.
Ram.
Okay, so now I will ask you, Esha kaha, because this is next to me, right? But now when you answer, you will not say Esha Sadguru. You would want to say Saha Sadguru.
Saha Sadguru.
Because of the distance.
Yes, Acharya, remember initial classes, you know, you had shown the Hidimba book. So that time you had told Saha kaha. That was a question.
So
that I'm getting confused because the question also has Sa, and even to show the distance also is Sa.
Okay. No problem is online. when we are online, it's difficult to tell you the distance, right? So that is why I was actually keeping it like this, for example, and I was saying Saka. So that is why you probably got confused. I was actually saying who is she at a distance, and I should have said Esha ka, which is more correct, because it is near to me, and then you would answer that sa something, sa lata or sa hidimba. But it is good. See, now when we initially learn sa and esha, sometimes you would use exchangeably just because the distance is confusing. You might also argue that how much distance is here? Is it 2 feet, 5 feet? Till where I should say this, and till where should
Yeah,
I start?
that was one of the question one of the students raised, and the answer she gave was like, it is not real, it is not tied to not only to distance. You can't always tie Asha and Sa to distance. But even if you go to if you go to an event and there are like small groups within your group, you can say Esha, Eshaha, and then outside your group, even though they are near, you can say Saha,
Sa.
Sa, like that.
It's more of the awareness also. So not just real distance, but awareness that I am aware of this person. So what you just said is perfect example, the group example. So my group versus somebody else or something else. So my group is everybody is Esha and Esha. But even if next person is not looking at you, they are involved somewhere else. So then you will say Saha.
Just like I think it is the same way we use in other regional languages also, whether it be Telugu, Kannada or
Even
Hindi or
Hindi, वो
Tamil.
कौन है से यू विल से हु इज ही सो एंड हु इज दिस सो इन इंग्लिश समटाइम्स यू से दिस फॉर इवन पर्सन्स व्हेन दे आर नियर टू यू देन यू विल से हु इज दिस एंड देन एट अ डिस्टेंस यू विल से हु इज दैट सो गीता जी डज दैट हेल्प
Sort of. Maybe as we go on further, maybe I understand it better.
Okay. See, as long as you remember Sa and Esha are both for strilings, you will be able to decide whenever you are actually using it whether to use Esha or Sa. If you want to really think
या
of to
गीता महोदय आचार्य जी कैन आई स्पीक
या गो अहेड प्लीज
या आई जस्ट वांटेड टू से सिंस आचार्य महोदय एंड ऑल ऑफ अस वी आर नॉट इन अ ट्रेडिशनल क्लासरूम सेटिंग इट माइट सम थिंग्स माइट बी डिफिकल्ट टू एक्सप्लेन एंड अंडरस्टैंड आई डू हैव अ वीडियो which clearly shows how to use saha and eshaha, all those things. I'll send that to you.
No, because it's interactive session and I like it. It's very interesting, so that's why it's clarifying my
So I can see, even I can say Eshah Sadguru, right, Gita ji? And now I can say Sahasadguru. Because now I am holding at a distance from me also. So I just trying to help you with the difference that Sahasadguru versus Esha
Yeah,
Sadguru.
sure. Okay.
सह रिच डैड अथवा पुअर डैड
सह रिच डैड
उत्तमम उत्तमम सो टुडे आई थिंक वी विल स्टॉप हियर कक्षा समाप्त रिकॉर्डिंग एंड फ्यू अदर वर्ड्स आल्सो इफ यू गेट इंटरेस्टेड इन फाइंडिंग सम or discovering some new words, please bring them to the class. We can.
I have. I don't know whether new words, but can somebody? I think somebody is making a lot of noise.
I will mute one second. Hang on. Okay, now go ahead.
I was just saying that not new in I don't know about new words. We will I will find out the appropriate. I'll try to find something appropriate for record or recording. I have created a spreadsheet.
Okay.
Like this has been my project on the side. You know, words that are available in English, which have roots in Sanskrit and other Indian languages.
Oh, nice. Okay.
So yeah, so I can share that if anybody is interested.
Yeah, that will be nice.
And okay, I'll share that in the group.
Make some of the people as editors to that sheet. So if somebody
Add, yeah, that's the idea. That's the idea. So
we can discuss
everybody
those.
If
so, whoever okay, adds, okay. Let's say one word, bring it to the class also next time. That okay, I found this word and let us talk about it.
Yeah. Because I don't know all the regional languages, right? So I did whatever best I could, so
mm-hmm. It would be nice.
Yeah.
That would be nice.
Yeah, sure. I will share that link.
Okay, perfect. Uttamam sarvesham namo namaha. Shubh ratri. Shubh ravivasarah.
Dhanyavadah. Sarvesham namo namaha. Shubh ratri.
Shubh ratri.
Sarvesham namo namaha.
Shubh Ratri. Shubh Ratri.